because since 1947, Kashmir happens to be an active conflict zone. And we have the presence of more than 600,000 troops in Jammu and Kashmir, and which is highest anywhere in the world in so-called peace time. And since 1989, when young Kashmiris picked up arms to fight against the Indian occupation in Jammu and Kashmir, Indian state responded with a heavy military might and with brutalization. So it has resulted in the killing of more than 70,000 people. More than 8,000 people have disappeared in Jammu and Kashmir since last 23 years. If you see, even today, young boys are being arrested because they participated in the protests of 2008 and 2010 and even 2011 and 12 and 13. So all these years, young boys who did not pick up arms, who were participating in the protests, so they are being now victimized. They are now being arrested, tortured, brutalized. In Jammu and Kashmir is a military occupation. To sustain its military occupation in Jammu and Kashmir, they are perpetrating human rights violations and killing people, incarcerating people, torturing people, disappearing people. So therefore, that is the context. So one of our demands, the primary demands, is that the right of self-determination of the people of Jammu and Kashmir, human rights violations in Jammu and Kashmir do have a context. So therefore, that context has to transform first, which is that self-determination. People be asked, how do they want to live in a future, whether they want to be free or whether they want to be part of Pakistan. Then, till right of self-determination is practiced in Jammu and Kashmir, we have other demands, like the end of, there has to be abrogation of all the draconian laws, like Armed Forces Special Powers Act and other draconian laws like that. What we are saying is that all the people who have been responsible for these crimes, whether they are from army, whether they are from police, whether they are from CRPF or BSF, people who have been responsible for massacres, people who have been responsible for rapes and forced disappearances, people who have been responsible for torture, there should be cases against them, and these people should be prosecuted and punished. We recently brought out a report in which we studied 214 cases, and we found out that there are government inquiries indicting 500 police, army, BSF, CRPF officials who have been indicted of their role for their role in different crimes, but they have never been punished. Some of the senior officers include like the ex-DGP of police, Kuldeep Khadda, the present additional DGP of police like Mr. Sahai, SM Sahai, and many others like this. So if they still continue to be in power, if they still continue to be in government, that is adding salt to the wounds of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. These people need to be taken to the task. They have to be punished for the crimes. The other demand is that these people, the family members of these people who have been victimized, who have suffered human rights violations, there should be proper reparations for them. They should be compensated for the losses.
What's the relevance of our media, alternate media, so alternate media is concerned in highlighting these human rights issues?
There is a very unfortunate reality about Jammu and Kashmir conflict, which is that it's not just Indian Army and Jammu and Kashmir Police or the Indian intelligence organizations which are responsible for persecuting the people of Jammu and Kashmir. All of them have another arm, an unofficial arm, which is the Indian media. The Indian media has played a very unfortunate role, a very criminal role, in not highlighting the human rights violations, but also what they've done, which is criminal, which is legitimizing the violence of the Indian Army in Jammu and Kashmir, legitimizing the role of the Indian Army in Jammu and Kashmir. What they have done is unpardonable, and they have created a huge support for Indian Army in India for crimes which they have perpetrated in Jammu and Kashmir. So in the common ordinary masses in India have been mesmerized with an image of a valiant Indian Army, the brave Indian Army. The Indian Army, the role which they have played here, needs to be told to the people of India so that there is some change in the mindset of the people of India and there is no support for these crimes. But Indian media has garnered a support based on lies, based on deception. So that disservice which has been done by the mainstream Indian media could be now undone by an alternate media, which is not corporate media, which is not driven by the interests of nation, which is not driven by the interests of the state. If there is a real alternate media, that alternate media can question the lies of the mainstream media. And I think that would be a very great, significant help for the people of Jammu and Kashmir.
What would you suggest us more to do so that we'll push up these stories to the world audience?
You know, there are many stories of Jammu and Kashmir which are still unreported. People of world, people of India need to know the human face of the people of Jammu and Kashmir, the sufferings of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. They need to be told actually what and how people of Jammu and Kashmir have lived their lives in the last 23 years. All stories are important stories. Like, for example, these days we have an issue of these militants who have returned from Pakistan. They look at the lives which they are living now. Recently there was one ex-militant who returned from Pakistan. He committed suicide in Crore area. And his family will have to live hand to mouth now. They are in a very bad condition now. So there are many other families, there are many other ex-militants who returned from Pakistan with the promise from government of India that they will be rehabilitated. And they have been deceived by government of India again. So what will happen to them? What I suspect is many of them are wanting to commit suicide now. And who is responsible? Unfortunately, not just government of India, but also people here, all of us, media, for not talking about them, human rights organizations for not taking their case, and society at large. So we'll all have to work for the protection of their rights. Unfortunately, Kashmir is not very attractive conflict zone for the international opinion makers, for the international community. We are not Palestine, which catches the attention of the world. We are not Syria. We are not Iraq. We are not oil rich. So we don't have much to offer to the world. But people of Kashmir are suffering exactly the way people of Afghanistan, people of Syria, people of Palestine, people of Rwanda, or people of East Timor and other places were suffering. But international community did play a positive role. We may be a small country and we may be a place which is suffering through a democracy. And unfortunately, India is seen as a country of Gandhi. But the truth about Kashmir needs to be told to the people of the world that there is no Gandhi. Gandhi has long back died. And India represents the policies of Hitler only. And we are living the Nazi era in a different way now. And people of the world need to pay attention exactly the way they paid attention for East Timor, exactly the way they paid attention to South Sudan, or they paid attention to Montenegro and other places. I think Kashmir requires attention of the world. Kashmiri people are suffering unfortunately unheard.